Welcome to Soft Tribute. Today we are going to look at some of the alternatives that can be used for Midjourney, and most of these are free and some of them are even unlimited, and you can use it as many times as you want without any restrictions. So watch the video till the end. I'll be covering a lot of informative points in this video, so don't miss out on any of those information. So the first one is called BlueWillow. This is the homepage of that website, and it also works similar to Midjourney, and it's in a Discord server, and you can just log in and click on the join the beta button, and it will take you to this Discord server. And once you enter there, you can see the FAQs. And as you can see, these are some of the rules and questions that's normally asked. And as you can see, it's free for now, and you have unlimited prompts with this, and it works similar to Midjourney. In order to start using this, you need to go to the rookie section here and just click on it, where you will have the option to input your prompts. Just give a backslash and it will give that imagine. Just select that imagine section and you will have the option to enter the prompt. I have already saved a prompt and I'll just copy and paste it here. A cute adorable baby phoenix, and the resolution is 8K. You can also give aspect ratio here if you'd like. Now for this example, I'm just giving it as it is, and just click on enter and it will go. And it will start working on that prompt. As you can see, this is a community tab where all the other members are also using prompt to make their images. So that's one disadvantage of using this community prompt. You'll have to actually find it in this group of other prompts. So once it's ready, you will see like a highlighted color, and that's the image that I gave the prompt for, and this is how it looks. It will always give like four images from we can choose from, and we can click on the button below and you can upscale the version that you liked. And you have also the option to create variations of the same as well. So that's what U1 and V1 denotes. U1 is for upscaling the selected image, and V1 is for getting the variations of the same image. So once you upscale, it will take some time, and it's trying to upscale the image. As you can see, the animation just stopped and the button changed to green color. That means our upscaled image is ready. Now we have to find it from this feed, and let's just scroll down and see where our as you can see, that's the image as is highlighted with the yellowish color, and that's the upscaled version. So this is just a small tutorial on how to use this website. Now this is the upscaled version. The second website is called Dali, which is from the famous OpenAI website who is behind ChatGPT, and we can sign in using our Gmail account. Once you sign in, you will get 50 credits for free, and every month 15 credits will be added free of cost. If you need extra, you'll have to pay for it. So once you are logged in, this is the dashboard, and it is just a simple dashboard. You have the option to upload an image to edit, and you also can give a text prompt so that you can convert it into image. I'm using the same image prompt to see how it will generate the output. Let's just wait and see. This is how it looks. This website is pretty fast when compared to other websites. The generation time is much less compared to the others. Now let's just wait for our image, and as you can see, it generated four variations of the same prompt, and all of this looks really good. If you want, you can just download it and go to the back button. And that's how simple it is to actually use this website, and as you can see, the pricing is also mentioned there. The next website on our list is InstantArt, and this is also an unlimited free generation website. As you can see, when you click on an image, you have the option to download and you can see the prompts that other people are using. You have also the option to search using a keywords, and you can find the images that the community generated. And when you click on generate, it will take you to this section where you can actually add your prompt and click on the generate button. They give you like different models and different dimensions that you can choose from. The only downside of this website is this can be a bit slow, and sometimes the image generation can fail. As you can see, I have finally got that image which I gave the prompt for. Now let's click on it and see, and as you can see, this is how the image looks like. And now let's go to the home page and see what the community members are actually generating images for. As you can see, it can generate good realistic images based on the prompt that you give. And if you know how to give good prompts, you can definitely generate some good images with this. Now let's look at our fourth option. This website is called DreamlikeArt, where you can create images free. And for that, you need an account. And this is not unlimited. This is based on a credit-based system. And you just need to create account using your Google account. And just click on your Google account, and then it will create an account for you there. So it has got like three main models, and this is the default model. It will take like 7 credits just to create this 5 images, and it's using DreamLike Diffusion 1.0, and you can see the image quality is really good, and I really like the output that it's generating. And this is their another model, like DreamLike Photoreal, and it's taking more credits, like 12 credits, and it's generating even better pictures with this. I like the quality of this as well. This images looks really good, and the colors are also really great. And this is the last model with stable diffusion, and it's taking 4.8 credits to generate. Comparatively low credits, and this image is not looking that great when compared to these previous images. You also have different options here. If you like, you can make even more variations using this button, and you can just have the aspect ratio, and you can make it public or private. And for the pricing, now let's look at the pricing of this. If you go to the settings and down there, you can see the pricing, and there is $15, $75, and $30. And for free, how it works is like you will get initially 50 credits. Then if you are online for 48 hours, the last 48 hours, you will get 1 credit every hour. So 1 credit will be added every hour if you are online for the past 48 hours. So that's how it works. It replenishes every hour. So you can, if you are not planning to use it like in a hurry, then this is definitely a good choice for you. Now let's look at the fifth option. This is called playground.ai, and here you get 1000 image credits per day, which is more than enough, and you have the commercial rights as well. This is one of the favorite tools that I use right now, and you also get a feed where you can see the images that's generated by the community members, and you have the option to hide it if you don't like to show it publicly, and that feature is also there for free. And once you hover over every image, you can see the prompt, and you can save it if you want. And that's a very good way of actually creating your own image with styles. If you don't know how to prompt images, you can just copy the prompts from here, and you can work on your own images. So these are some of the images that's created by the community. If you would like it to create your own image, just click on that create button, and this is where you add your prompt. Let's add that prompt that we used everywhere. You also have Dali too, but that's a paid add-on, and you can use Stable Diffusion 2.1 and 1.5. You also have image dimensions that you can select from, and you can choose the prompt guidance and seed and the number of images that needs to be generated. The main reason I like this website is because of this pre-filters. It allows us to play with a lot of filters, and you don't need to be an expert to actually create image using Playground, because everything is pre-filtered, and you just need to click on the filter that you like and you can create images accordingly. As you can see, there are many filters that you can choose from. And now for this example, I am using woodless filter that will apply like a wood kind of an image to the face and body. And you can also change the number of columns there. When you click on action, you will get even more options to create variants, face restoration, upscale to 4x, and you can also edit images using this website. So this is the output that it generated when I selected that filter, and as you can see, we also have the option to rate the images, and we also have a lot of other filter as well. And let's look at one more filter, play tune, and we'll generate the same image using the same prompts. Let's see how it comes. As you can see, it looks like a Playtoon animation type of image, and if you want, you can change it to like another style. Let's click on this cinematic effect. Let's apply a cinematic filter to this one, and let's see what it will generate for that filter. You can play around with this and change the filter according to your preference. So that's a good way of generating different styles from single prompt. Now our cinematic style filter is ready, and this is how that image looks. Now let's look at delicate detail filter and see what it can generate. As you can see, everything is coming up with different image ideas. And now the other option we have is like we can upload an image and make changes to the image using the help of AI. For example, I can just type in add sunglass, then for this image it will add sunglass. As you can see, now this robot is wearing like sunglasses. And if I like type in make it like black and white image, then it can do that as well. As you can see, the image is now black and white. So we have these options as well with Playground, and if you want, you can save, otherwise let's just cancel. So this is Playground in a nutshell. It can do a lot of things. Go to profile, you can see the images that you generated, and if you click on my likes section, then it will take you to the pictures that you liked from the community tab. You can use all these images and take it as inspiration and copy the prompt and modify it with different filters for your future projects. So that's a good way of finding prompts and the styles that you like and using in your projects if you don't know how to create prompts. Now let's look at the six on our list, and it is called Lexica. This is one of the best, I would say, in terms of image quality, and it's really soft and the colors really pop out. And these are some of the images that's created using this website, and as you can see, you can see the different variations, and once you click on it, you will see the different prompts that's used to create these images as well. and it also acts like a search engine for images, where you can search, you can type in your search query and it will fetch images from its database of images where people created all these images. And you also have the option to filter it using the stable diffusion 1.5 and Lexica aperture. And this Lexica aperture is a proprietary filtration system developed by Lexica team, so that's why the image quality is really different when compared to stable diffusion 1.5. As you can see, the images really pop out from the rest of the images. And if you want, you can just type in, for example, like Superman, and it will search its database for the image and it will shows the images related to Superman. You can also search by image relevancy and prompt, and you can also select stable diffusion and Lexica aperture, and these are the options available in the search section. Now let's go to the generate area. I have already generated the image using the same prompt that I was using, and I have exhausted the limit for the free account. I'll have to wait till the next month for my new 100 credits. So this is the output that I got using the prompt. It's really great. I really like this image quality. And for pricing, you have $8 per month, 27, 24 and 48. As you can see, I have already exhausted the 100 images for this month. Now I'll have to wait till next month to get it replenished. So this is these are my favorite text to image generation tools that I use nowadays, and all of these are free and some of them are even unlimited. And hope you like this selection of tools. If you learned something new and if you got value out of this video, please consider subscribing and liking this video so that it will inspire me to do more videos like this. And thank you for watching. Have a great day.